everyone, I'm Professor Savita Burke, and in the today's lecture, we are going to understand the meaning and definition of macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is the branch of economics that studies the behavior and performance of an economy as a whole. Economics is having two branches. One is a microeconomics and another is a macroeconomics. In this lecture series, we are going to discuss regarding the macroeconomics. So, macroeconomics is the branch of economics that studies the behavior and the performance of the economy as a whole. The behavior and the performance of the economy as a whole is nothing but your macroeconomics. It focuses on the aggregate changes in an economy, such as unemployment, growth rate, gross domestic product, and inflation. Always this macroeconomics is focusing on the overall changes in an economy. But what kind of changes? Changes in the unemployment rate, changes in the growth rate, changes in the gross domestic product. Now, what is the meaning of gross domestic product? The gross domestic product is the concept of economics. It means that the total value of goods produced and services provided in a country during the 1 year. And inflation means the rises in the prices of commodities. Now, what is the meaning of inflation? Let's take a simple example. Suppose for this pen, I am spending this year 10 rupees to purchase this pen. Maybe to purchase the same pen, I have to spend 12 rupees in the next year. So the product is same, but I am spending the higher price. That is nothing but your inflation. So macroeconomics is the branch of economics that studies the behavior and performance of the economy as a whole, and it focuses on the overall changes in the economy, such as unemployment, growth rate, gross domestic product, and inflation. Now we are going to understand the definition of macroeconomics. Now we are having the two definitions of macroeconomics. The first definition is given by the professor Kenneth. He says that macroeconomics deals not with the individual quantities as such, but the aggregate of those quantities, not with the individual income, but with the national income, not with the individual prices, but with the price level, not with the individual output, but with a national output. As we have already seen that, what is the meaning of your macroeconomics? We are going to consider all the overall factor or the large scale factors. So Professor Kenneth says that macroeconomics deals not with the individual quantity, because we are going to study the overall economic changes. So that's why not with the individual quantities as such, but the aggregates of those quantities. Aggregates means the overall of those quantities, not with the individual income. We are not going to discuss anything about the individual income, but we are going to discuss about the national income. National income is the income of your nation during a particular year, and not with the individual prices, but with the price level. Again, we are going to discuss about the overall things. Not with the individual output, but with the national output, means how much the output is generated by the individual firm. We are not going to compute that, but how much is the total production at the national level, that we are going to consider it. Now, the second definition is given by the Professor Hansen. He says that macroeconomics is the branch of economics which considers the relationship between large aggregates such as volume of employment, total amount of savings, investment, national income, etc. Now, Professor Hansen says that macroeconomics is the branch of economics which consider a relationship between the large aggregates, means again we are going to concentrate on the overall factors such as the volume of employment, means how much people are actually employed in the economy. The total amount of saving, again, we are not going to discuss anything about the individual savings, that is the national savings. Then investment, that is at the national level investment, and the national income, etc. This is the definition given by the Professor Hansen. I guess that you have understood this concept. Thank you so much.